Hello everyone, welcome back. This is Ibrahim Qureshi and welcome to VMware tutorial for beginners. This is session 5. In this session we are going to cover what is a virtual machine. So let's get started, and today we are going to talk about what is a virtual machine and how to and installing a new virtual machine on our newly set up vCenter server, which we did on the session 4. Okay, then let's get started. So what is actually a virtual machine? So it's not a physical machine, it's a virtual machine. It's actually living inside a physical host. So what class is it as a virtual machine? It is like a software. So ESX host basically considered it like a file, really. So you can move it around, obviously copy it, clone it, you know, you can increase the memory on the fly if you have hot add enabled. So it's like a collection of files. So hence why we have the concept of virtual CPU, virtual memory. The disk itself is called VMDK, the hard drive where you install the OS. So it's called a virtual disk. In VMware terminology, it's called VMDK. And also you have virtual network adapters. You can have 1, 2, 3, how many you want, really. You can keep on adding them. You also have a concept of virtual hardware, because the virtual machine needs some sort of hardware. So VMware created virtual hardware. There are different versions of virtual hardware available based on which version of ESX host and vCenter you're using. Also we have another concept of VMTools, which basically gives you better performance if you have the latest tools running and latest tool installed, and if they are running, then you get better performance on the VM. Okay, so let's look into a little bit more what these collection of files are. So a virtual machine file, basically we will do a demo of how to install a VM, and once we install a VM, we'll open and check out the files which it gets created. The reference for all these files are from docs.vmware.com. The most important file is .vmd vmx file, which is the configuration of the virtual machine, which has like configuration as obviously how many virtual CPUs, how many memory it has, so those sort of things. And then we have some more additional config on vmxf. The very famous vmdk is the hard drive, so it always comes up as whatever name I have chosen for the virtual machine .vmdk. So it's also called the virtual disk characteristics. So it is the virtual disk, which is where the OS is installed. Again, the data disk, which is also called the flat file, which is actual data of the OS where it is installed. So it can be, you know, 3 gig, 4 gig, 20 gig, 30 gig. How much big the OS grows, the flat file grows, file grows as well. So NVRAM, this is the virtual memory BIOS. So this is how the server is booting, whether it's booting by BIOS or if we boot. And then you have virtual machine snapshot, so you can take a snapshot as a point and time restore. So if you are doing any changes to the virtual machine, you can take a snap, do your changes, and then if it goes belly up, you can revert back to as it was before you made any changes. So that's a point in time restore, really. But it's not meant to be kept for, you know, more than 72 hours. That's what we recommend, to use it, and as soon as you're done, delete the snapshot. Then we have swap file, which is like a virtual memory within the virtual machine. Other files we have is log file and vmss file, which is for if you suspend the virtual machine, that's when it is used. So these are generic files which we get when you create a virtual machine. So let's start a demo. Okay, let's get started. Let me open my vCenter. We already did a session on installing the vCenter. For all of the virtualization VMware administrator out there, vCenter is a primary tool for managing your environment. So you can manage everything from here, all the VMs, hosts. You can set up and configure high availability, DRS. So all these terms we'll learn as you go along, but today using this vCenter, this is the new one which we built in the last session. If you remember, the IP address is 192.168.1.90. I have added the physical host which I had, which is here, which is the Dell Optiplex which I have running at my lab. If you click on the host, so this is a data center. London is the data center. SA-London is the cluster, and this is the physical host. As you can see, it's saying it's using very little CPU, but it's using around about 19-20 GB of memory and nearly 200 GB of storage. So you can have a quick look like this on the resources. So let's create a new virtual machine. So you can right click on the cluster or the host. Let's right click on the host and then select new virtual machine. Create a new virtual machine. Next, name of the virtual machine, I want to say for the purpose of this test, test Win10, which is a Windows 10 machine which we are going to create now. Next, keep an eye on here. So every time we do something, it's saying compatibility check succeeded. So every step which we are taking, VMware is validating what we are doing, whether it can obviously accommodate the request or not. So again, data store I have selected is selected the 2 TB disk. At the moment I have 1.5 TB free here. This is the SSD. I don't want to use that. There's only 100 GB anyway. So next. So compatibility is going to be ESX 6.7 or later, which is fine. Select next. This is an important screen. So OS family, based on this, the hardware of the virtual machine is decided. So I have selected OS family is Windows, but you have Linux and others. If you select Linux, you can see have flavors of Debian, CentOS, Red Hat. So it's customized for each OS. If you select other, you have Apple, Oracle, and even ESX servers for doing virtual ESX. Let's get back to Windows. In Windows, you have different flavors again. So we are going to go down and select Windows 10 64-bit. Select next. So hardware customization. So I'm going to give 2 CPUs. Actually, we can give 4 CPUs. And then memory 4 GB should be enough. However, on the hard disk, I do not want to give 32 GB for just installation. So give it 20. And then also I want to change this thick provisioning to thin. The concept of thick and thin provisioning is a big concept really. But what I want to show for the purpose of this video, if we select thin provisioning, it's going to only use the amount of data which is saved on the VM. So if I only install the VM, which is going to take 2-3 GB, then it's going to only use 2-3 GB from the 1.5 TB which I have. If I say thick or eagerly zero, which I have, thick provision eagerly zero or lazy zero, thick provision lazy zero, then it will straight away assign that 20 GB and I'll lose the 20 GB, although I'm not actually having 20 GB of data to consume. So it's always better to, you know, select thin provisioning, and then you can have better capacity moving forward. So this is the final screen. It shows all the summary of what we have selected. It says the guest operating system is Windows 10. We have given 4 CPUs, 4 GB memory. It has a network card E1000A, and it has the capacity 20 GB which we have given, and it's going to be installed on this data store. Let's click finish. Now if you remember, in our slides we were discussing about some files when you create a virtual machine. Let's have a look at these files. So not all the files will be created when we create a virtual machine. I'll show you how. So if you select my virtual machine, which is test win 10 which we just created, and go to data stores, select browse. So this is the storage side. As you can see, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 tabs. First one is host and clusters, the second one is VM and templates, the third one we are looking at now is storage. So the VM is stored on the local storage at this moment of the host. Let's select the VM which we just created. I just want to expand this a little bit so that you can read the names properly. It's getting a little bit trickier to hold this. Okay, let's just select it from here. Why not? So there you go, it does the same thing. So we have 4 files only. So I have the hlogs, .hlogs, and the vmtest, vmsd, and vmdk, which is the flat file, and the vmx file, which is the configuration file. So if you look at the presentation, so I have the vmx file, vmsd file, which is the virtual machine snapshot file, and then the flat file, which is the vmdk file, and there's a log file there as well. So this will change as soon as I power on. It will create all these files, which is the memory file and the swap file. The swap files and all these will be created. Let's have a quick look. So let's go back to host and clusters, power this on, right click, power on. So we just powered on the VM. Quickly open the console as well. Open console. It has come here, as you can see, test win01. So let's quickly mount the disk anyway. So the reason I open VMRC, which is VMware remote console, is we can easily mount the disk. Select remote devices, disk, and then connect disk from ISO. And I have ISO in my temp directory on my C drive. It's in the temp directory, Microsoft Windows 10. Just need to click enter. Should pick up once we do a power cycle. Send control done. There you go. Just pick up the ISO. Let the ISO boot. In the meanwhile, let's go back to the vCenter server. Here, and then check the files again. Our server is, let me just increase the font a little bit so you can see. So test vCenter, there you go. So it has got so many files created now. You can see the VMX tilt file, the log file is generated, the swap file is created because the memory is going to be allocated on the disk, 4 gig memory. That's why this is 4 gig. And then this is the flat file, the VMDK file, the flat, the actual virtual disk. The NVRAM file is created. So, and this is the VMX configuration file. So as you can see, the difference once we power on, there are quite a lot of files which were created. Great, we are here on the installation phase now. Good timing. Let's click next, click install. I'm not going to go through the entire installation because that will take a lot of time. I do not want to extend the video time for more than 20 minutes. So as I was saying, I'm not going to go through the entire installation of Windows 10. I'm going to pause it so that I keep the length of my video within 20-22 minutes. So I've accepted the terms and conditions and click in. I always use custom, I don't know why, but I like it this way. So that's the 20 gig which we have given to the server. Click new and then apply, so it will create its own partitions for MBR, for boot partition, system partition, and the primary partition. So there you go, recovery partition it has created, system MSR it's calling, so I think it's the master boot MB. So that's also reserved, I guess. And this is the primary one where we are going to install. So you can see the size has gone down to 19.4 instead of 20 gig. So it has partitioned it. So select next and then let's start the installation. I'm going to pause for now. And then once the installation is completed, we will log in and try to connect to the VM. Okay, so the installation is completed now. The test Windows 10 machine which I created, the VM called test Windows 10, is now successfully installed. Let's click to it later. Use express settings. It's going to restart the Windows machine. And then we will have this machine running. Okay, so that was our first VM installation. Hope you guys are excited and hope you guys have built your own labs at home to try this out. So let's quickly go through what we have discussed. We discussed how to create a new virtual machine and how we are leveraging the vCenter server and the ESX host and creating a new virtual machine. So if you have any questions, reach out to me at Ibrahim Qureshi. My blog is ibrahimqureshi.com. You'll find most of the videos which I'm doing along with the blog post, like the vCenter server, the ESX server, the nested installation. You'll find it on my blog. So don't forget to check them out. Don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and share it with your friends and ask them to share it on the social media as well. Okay, so it's the time for the question of the day. What is the extension of the hard disk file? VMname dot, what is the extension? So I have put XXXX because it is 4 characters. Comment down below. Or if you want another question, what type of disk provisioning did I use in my demo today? Was it thick provisioning Eagerly Zero, thick provisioning Lazy Zero, or thin provisioning? So hope you guys enjoy watching this and see you in the next episode. Cheers, bye.